Hi all. In this video, let's learn about React form validation using Formic and Yupp libraries. So without using any of the libraries also, we can validate the React forms using the React itself. So for that, let's see an example. So this is an app root component. In that, we are importing form component. So this is a normal React way of validating the forms. So the first thing we will be doing is we need to take the initial values. We need to take the state, use state for maintaining the form values, and also we need to maintain one more object for the errors and one more object whether to submit or not. Okay, so this is what we need to state the states initially. So later on we need to write the submit button, on submit button, handle change function whenever the value changed in the form. So this method would be triggered and we are persisting that values in the state. So and later on we'll write the handle submit function. So when we submit, we are calling the validate form. So here we are writing this is our own validation. So we are validating the email and the password with the regular expressions. So this is what usually we do while we are working with the normal React form validations. So also you need to keep, we'll be keeping the value, form values.email. We'll be writing the events, and also we'll write some span for the errors. So we need to handle the form errors. Dot email, and based upon this, if the form errors consists of any error related to email, this span would be enabled. So this is how we'll be writing the normal React forms validation. So here if you see, the code is very much more, and this is like if the form fields are more, then the code will be increasing and it would be like pain process. Whereas coming to Formic and Yupp, if you use Formic and Yupp libraries, they will make this process painless process. So for that, let's see an example and let's learn about this Formic and Yupp, how they will help us. So I will explain about both the libraries. So initially how to install them is npm install Formic and Yupp. So I'm installing both the Formic and Yupp libraries with a one command, package one space package two. If I click enter, we'll be installing both the Formic and Yupp libraries. So by the time it installs, so let me explain you about what is a Formic. So Formic is a simple library. So it helps in three ways like this. So whatever the value you enter in the form, that would be in, it would take that value, and also it will show that value when it is necessary. It means it will maintain the form state. Also, it will validate the form fields, and if there are any errors, it will show those errors. It will also handle the form submission things. So these are the three steps Formic will help us. So let's see how we need to install and use the Formic and Yupp libraries. So once you install Formic and Yupp, you'll be getting like this. So I will go back to the code. So once you install, you need to import them wherever you want to use that. So I'm importing Formic, the container, and form. So this is generally an input form. This is like a form in the HTML form. So we'll be using the form component of Formic. Field, it would be like an input field and error message to show the error message. So we'll be importing these four components from Formic library. So let me explain one by one. So this is how we are going to install. This is the Formic component, the root component. This will take three parameters. Number one is the initial values. So what is our form and what are the form fields? We need to mention them and we need to give them initial values. So those initial values, form initial values, will be taken as the first parameter. And the second parameter is the validate. So here we'll be providing a function where this is very much similar to what we have defined, like validate function to validate our form fields. So this is our own custom function. So and the third parameter is how to handle the form. So once you submit the form, what we need to do? So that one would be the third prop for the Formic component. So these are the three properties for the Formic, and later on it will accept the render props pattern. So that's the reason it is able to get this Formic prop, in which I will print this Formic and I will show what all the properties available in this Formic. Before that, I will show how the structure is defined. So Formic is the root component. This is the form component where all the fields, our form fields, will go inside this form. Okay. So, and later on, this field is like an input field. Okay. And in this form field, The main important property is the name, name email. This name property is the main important in all the things, like in the initial value, you need to mention as a name, and also to the field, you need to mention the name property as email, and also to the error message. So this is also a component. And whenever this field fails, then this component will enable. Okay, till that point, this component will be in disabled mode. Whenever this field, whenever this error object consists of error, in this error object, if email consists of any errors, then only this message would be enabled. And here we are taking this component as a span. So here we are not keeping any logic whether to show this email if it is error, or if it is not error, don't show this message. Like that, we are not keeping any logic. Just we have kept an component called error message, and only we are giving the name property. So the same name property for the field we'll be using. So this is how, if there is any error in this field, this error message would be automatically, it will enable. So this is how we are going to define the fields in the form and error messages one after the other. So if you observe here, we are not writing any onChange events. Okay. Also, we are not writing any onChange events, so that this field, why we are not writing any onChange fields is this field value will automatically link the onChange events with the formic change events, so that whatever the values, form values are modified, those are automatically updated with the formic. So formic will sync the state of these fields with the state which is it is defined. So that's the reason we are not defining any use states here, because this formic has a capability to read these form fields and sync them with the state values. So that's the main advantage here. Also, you no need to write any onChange events. So let me show you this example once. So here this formic will consist of all the properties which are available. So I will explain you with an example. So if I refresh this, so here you will be getting a formic. So I think we need to replace normal component with the formic component. So I will enable the formic component in the app.js so that now we can see the app component. So here validate. Okay. Also, why we need to use the UP library? I will explain you. So here why it is showing an error means we have used validate, but I have commented this validate. So usually this is how we write the custom validation function for the validate. Okay. Let me comment this. So this is a manual work which we are writing our regular expressions, and we are defining each and every field validations like this. Instead of this, we can, Formic team has one more approach. So they love UP library. Okay. UP is a JavaScript object schema library. So this Formic team, what have done, they have defined one more property called as validation schema. And with this schema, they will take one schema object so that they will validate the form fields. So that's the reason we are going to install UP library. So here comes with the UP library. So far, we no need UP library. Formic can handle all these things with this our validate property. If we want to validate the schema with a simpler steps, so then we need to use this validation schema property of Formic, and we need to provide the UP object schema here. So what is this library? So UP also we have installed. So we need to import like this. And later on, let's define this UP. So if you see this syntax, it is very much similar to the prototypes of React. So here UP, as we discussed, this is a JavaScript object, and it will define this shape. With the shape, we'll be defining the schema validator. This is known as a schema validator. So here the name email and this name and the field name should match. So that's the important step we need to understand. This field email, name email, and the name which we are defining here should match. So here we are defining an email field, and we are giving this up.string, and it means we are giving a value of string, and it should be evaluated with the email. And if there is no value given, we'll be showing this message, email is required. And we are just keeping an email, that's it. And it will evaluate the email validation. So here what we are doing, we are writing a regular function to evaluate the email field. But here we are just giving an email method like this. So in this way, we can give n number of methods like this. So UP library helps us to validate. It will make the validations very much easy. So just we need to define the schema like this for all the form fields. For example, we are again defining one more field, password, and we are giving it is required field, and we are mentioning its minimum value. If the length is not more than 4 characters, we'll be getting a message like this. We also can give min and max properties as well. So here we'll be having an UP library. So here it will be providing an email. So if you observe here, it validates the value as per the email address. So it will validate whether the email is valid or not. Also, it has n number of values like this. So min, max, everything. It would be automatically calculated these values. You no need to keep or write any validations or any regular expressions for that. So that's the reason we are going to use this UP validation schema. So that we are defining these validations in a simple English, in a simple methods. Not we are not defining any regular expressions like this. Okay, to remove this overhead painful logic, we are using UP library. So that's the reason, and Formic team loves this UP validation library, so that they have defined one more property called validation schema, and they are assigning this validation schema variable to that. Fine, this is how it works. So now let's see what this Formic values are consists of. So now let me refresh this again. So once if I refresh this, I will be getting the Formic object. So here the Formic object consists of these many properties. Okay. In this will, the importance is values. So this is the value which is synced with the state values. And also if you observe, as we discussed, on change, we are not writing any on change event. Okay. That on change event would be equivalent, automatically linked with the handle change event of the Formic. So that's the reason we are not writing any handle change, handle submit events. Those are automatically handled internally with the Formic. So if you enter any value here, this Formic will sync that value with this Formic values. So whatever value now you give here, that values will sync here. So that happens. So now if I'm giving a valid value, so it will be occurring. So if I not give any value, it will say password is required. And also if you observe, the button is not enabled here. So the reason behind this is from the Formic only, we are taking some properties. So here we have these many properties and we are taking some properties. Also, this is an error object. In this error objects, the errors will be going. Okay. So in this Formic, we'll be taking the few values like dirty. Let me explain here. So errors, this is an error object, which we'll be taking from this Formic property. This error object is used to show whether which field is error, which field is having error. And this touched means whether we touch that field or not. Is valid means the form is valid or not. Dirty means whether we entered any value or not. So like that, there would be n number of properties we are taking from Formic object. And also, if you see, the button is not enabled because we wrote a logic. Just we have used a property called is valid. If the property of is valid is false, it means the form is not validated. It means the form is not valid. So then we are keeping disabled true for this button. So that's the reason this button is disabled. Okay. Now if I enter any value and wantedly I'm removing these values. So email is also automatically validated. We did not wrote any custom validation to validate or regular expression. We did not wrote any regular expression, but it is validated automatically. Okay, fine. I have entered the email ID and the password. So now the field is enabled. Now, if you observe, in this Formic, the values value will holding the two values. So in this way, we no need to use any of the state variables or states to maintain or to get the values. Okay, automatically we'll be getting that values. In order to show that value, you can use like this. So Formic is an object and value is also another object, formic.values.email. So in this email, so you'll be having that email value, formic.values.password. In this password, you'll be getting this password value. If you want to use this value explicitly, you can use this. Okay. Once you submit the form, so you'll be getting the form values here. So all the state values. So all the form field values will be available in this values object. So here you can give an API call and you can submit your form. So once if I click that, you can see here, if I click that, you'll be getting those fields, form fields here. So here This on submit is directly handling the formic values. Here you have nowhere mentioned the that it should handle. Okay, but just by the click of the button, you are just keeping this as a type submit. So that's the reason this formic will directly handle this on submit. You're not writing any event for that. On submit, on change, on blur, all these events would be handled internally. Also, you are nowhere here you are using use states. Okay, those state value, all these form values are automatically synced with the state. Okay, this is how the formic works. Okay, and the UP library, we use mainly this UP library to define our JavaScript object schema validator. So we'll be just giving the field names and how the fields should work. That's it. Okay, this is very much easy. This is a painless process to validate the forms. Hope you understand this way of validating the React forms using the Formic and UP libraries. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.